Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Fallout 4. My name's Camel, and this video is going to be a walkthrough guide in which I will show you how to acquire the unique laser gun, known as prototype UP77, Limitless Potential. To get to this weapon, you will need to get through two novice level terminals, and also get into a master level locked safe. So either come with the appropriate perks already, or bring a companion that can help you get into that safe. For example, Kate. But once you've got that prepared, what we need to do is come to University Point. This can be found on the southern coast, and it is located to the southeast of Diamond City. Once here, we need to head into this building here on the east side of University Point. Once inside, turn to the right, and you will find this door that needs to be opened with this terminal. Simply hack the terminal. Once it is done, open the doors, get out of the terminal, and walk through the doors into the University Credit Union. Once inside, turn left and head down these stairs. At the bottom of the stairs, head through this unlocked security gate and straight to this novice level terminal. Again, use your elite hacking skills to open up the vault door. So once this vault door opens, we want to walk straight ahead, and in the middle of the middle row, there is a master locked safe. This is where you need to apply DEM lockpicking skills. Once it is open, we will find a button in there. Click this button and turn to the right to see the wall vanish. And before you is presented a secret area of University Point. Walk into the room, and on the table waiting for you is prototype UP77 Limitless Potential. Of course, be sure to pick it up. And as always, before modding it out and looking at the weapon's base stats, I have reduced all my character's special attribute stats to 1. I also have no bobblehead perk or magazine effects applied to my character. What this means is we will be seeing the absolute minimum base stats of the weapon. So in the first slot, we're going to be going with the overcharged capacitor. This increases damage by 75% and increases the magazine size to 33, but that doesn't matter. More on that later. For the barrel, I'm personally going with the improved sniper barrel. I want as much damage as possible. This makes the weapon semi-automatic, increases the damage by 125%, reduces magazine size, again, that means nothing. Increases minimum range by 11 times and increases maximum range by 18 times, reduces sight spread by 20%, increases spread by 100%, increases VATS cost by 35%, and increases sight time by 5%. Next, of course, we're going to be going with the recoil compensating stock. This turns the weapon into a rifle, reduces sight sway by 7%, reduces sight spread by 40%, reduces recoil by 30%, increases VATS cost by 20%, increases sight time by 10%, and increases bash damage by 100%. As always with the scopes, there are a number of options you can go with, but instead of turning this into a sniper, I decided to put reflex sights on. And again, I'll touch on this choice more later on in the video. But for now, the reflex sights. Adds 2x zoom, reduces sight spread by 15%, reduces VATS cost by 15%, and reduces sight time by 10%. And finally, I'm going to be going with the fine-tuned beam focuser. And because I'm not going with the scope, we could quite easily go with the quantum gyro compensating lens, but hey, the choice is yours. So the fine-tuned beam focuser increases range by +3x, reduces spread by 30%, and reduces recoil by 15%. And once it has been modded out the way I just did, it has a base energy damage of 72, it uses the fusion cells as ammunition, it has a fire rate of 50, its range is 263, its accuracy is 83, its weight is 7.6 pounds, and its value is 414 caps. And as we can see, up the top, prototype UP77 Limitless Potential. Unlimited magazine size. Now, first of all, that legendary effect I need to clarify a little bit, because people do get confused sometimes. Yes, the gun still uses ammunition, it just doesn't have any magazine clip. For example, if you have 2,000 fusion cells in your inventory, then the prototype UP77 Limitless Potential will have 2,000 clips in it ready to go. You never have to reload, but you do have to worry about burning through all of your ammunition. One of the reasons I didn't turn this into an automatic weapon. And this is the reason I was saying earlier, when adding certain modifications reduced or increased magazine size, and I mused that those factors didn't matter. Well, that's why, because they literally don't matter. Now, the biggest downside to using a laser gun with a sniper barrel is that the ammunition capacity is quite low. That's probably the biggest limiting factor of a sniper type laser gun. So this legendary effect of having an unlimited magazine size perfectly counters that. And yes, although you could go with a scope and use it as a sniper weapon, I did do this originally. That was my original original plan, but I found the recoil to be quite violent, and also the downside accuracy was quite bad. I was aiming at things not too far away via the long scope, and the accuracy was very poor. Probably 1 out of 4 times actually hitting the target I was aiming for, which is not what you look for with a sniper gun. So I thought, let's take the scope off, let's keep all the huge damage from the sniper barrel, completely negate the downsides of a small magazine size with this gun's legendary effect, and then put a reflex sight on it, so it's much more versatile and usable in close to medium ranged combat. And then of course, if you want, you can use it at long range, or you can just save the long range for VATS. Now its base energy damage was 72, and after I got all of the appropriate perks to increase the damage, I got the prototype UP77 Limitless Potentials damage up to 207. So 207 damage per shot on a semi-automatic rifle with no magazine capacity limitations, that is actually pretty good. Although of course you can get weapons that do much more damage in one hit, you can also get weapons that fire more quickly, but this is quite a nice middle ground. A pretty hefty per shot damage. Because of the reflex sights, we can now use it quite reliably in any form of combat at any range, and the huge negative of a tiny magazine size with a sniper barrel is completely gone. So all in all, with this mod build, it's actually a pretty nice weapon. And this legendary effect of an unlimited magazine size, it can be applied to pretty much any build of laser gun. I would warn to try and stay away from automatic weapons, as given you're never reloading, you never get that sobering reloading animation reminder that you do have a limited amount of ammunition. And in case you did buy the primer guide, this weapon is falsely listed as prototype PA77. Ha ha ha, what an embarrassing typo. And it also states that the weapon is found inside a safe, where in fact the button to open the room in which it is found within a safe. Right information, wrong order. If you like to drink 7-Up, you like this weapon, because it's UP77. And if you're having trouble doing an essay, grab this gun. After all, you might need a prototype. Ooh. And this gun is just like that all-you-can-eat concentrated sushi. After all, it is limitless potent eel. And speaking of limits, that's definitely the pun limit. Here it is, prototype UP77 Limitless Potential in action. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, I've been Camel, and this has been my walkthrough guide for the unique laser gun prototype UP77 Limitless Potential. Quite a mouthful. I do hope that this helped you out in some way, and if it did, please feel free to click on the playlist button on screen. This of course will take you directly to my Fallout 4 Guides playlist, where you can select the videos you wish to watch freely. Or you can check in the description, where it will be frequently updated with links to Fallout 4 Guides that I upload. If you, like me, enjoy sushi, please feel free to follow me on Twitter, the link can also be found in the description. And with all that said, I would like to thank you very much for watching. It has been an absolute pleasure, and I will see you very shortly in the next video. I'll see you there in a second.